I'm Dolores, and I'm here to start off your week fresh. For anyone who wants to enlist in the military, the ASVAB is today, Monday, in the library, so make sure you go now if you're taking it. Seniors, class of 2019, please purchase your cap and gown as soon as possible. Price for cap and gown is now $81. If you have any questions, see anyone in senior leadership or Ms. Solanoa in room 114. Thank you. If you're still interested in the Health Career Summer Internship Program, application deadline is this Friday, March 8th. Visit the CCRC for more information. We want to give a big congratulations to our Hostel Club who competed in the CTSO competition last Tuesday and Wednesday. Now for your favorite announcement and my favorite announcement, our lunch. Today we're having fish sandwich, rainbow salad, edamame, fruit juice, and milk. That's all for today, Rams. I'm Dolores, and I hope you have a Ram energizing week. Bye!
Second trivia. In which of these countries would you find the Nak Dong River? South Korea, North Korea, Vietnam, or Thailand? The Nak Dong is the second longest river in South Korea. It's found in the southeastern part of the country. For 3 months now, firefighters in South Korea have been battling blazes in an unusual place. A giant horseshoe-shaped trash pile. 11 years ago, a recycling business owner was given a permit to keep 2,000 tons of waste there. But in 2016, residents complained that trash was overtaking the area and the permit was canceled. After the site was sold to someone else in 2017, the previous owner was accused of dumping more than 80 times the amount of garbage allowed at the site. And the problem, like the trash heap itself, has flared up.
170,000 tons of illegal waste dumped on prime farming land. A health risk and an eyesore, South Korea is struggling to deal with its own rubbish. Park Hyun-soon has farmed here for 10 years. Her greenhouses are just meters from the expanding dump. First of all, there's the dust, she tells me. The greenhouse is a shell of plastic sheeting. The dust covers it up, blocks the light, and my eggplants are starting to grow gnarled. Since December, the dump is now starting to self-combust. As years-old waste decomposes, it produces flammable and toxic gases. Workers and firefighters douse the fire with water, only to see it reignite elsewhere.
The smell of burning household waste, of burning plastic, construction materials, is really quite unpleasant. And this is the winter time. It's sub-zero temperatures at the moment. Just imagine what this is like in the summer. One of those who lives very close by says she hasn't opened her windows in the past 2 years.
The company that owns this dump changed hands just over a year ago. The CEO tells CNN the previous owner dumped almost 170,000 tons of mostly illegal mixed waste at market rates that could raise more than $20 million. We were unable to contact him. Local officials say he's under investigation. They first took legal action 5 years ago to limit him to his original permit of a small storage site for recyclables. The government has now had to allocate a budget of $5 million for this, one official tells me. We plan to remove 21,000 tons of waste within the year. Illegal dumping is happening across the country and beyond. This is Mindanao in the Philippines. 6,500 tons of waste that a South Korean company had claimed was recyclable plastic synthetic flakes. In reality, it's filled with batteries, straws, electronic products, used diapers. After pressure from local environment groups, the South Korean government again had to step in and pay for its repatriation. China's decision to accept less of the world's waste and unscrupulous companies dumping illegally to make money means South Korea has a new waste reality to deal with. Paula Hancock's CNN, Wisong County, South Korea. Can we get away?